Record on. Okay. We are going to learn hypothesis testing, and my pronunciation may not be as per, you know, your expectations, because I learned hypothesis throughout my life and I cannot tongue my, you know, I can't twist my tongue as per the word is pronounced in USA. So please bear with me. So hypothesis testing, what is exactly this? Why we are doing this? And what is the importance of hypothesis testing? Again, this topic is related to inferential statistics, means based on the sample, we infer about population. So if this is clear, let me give you very simple, you know, example right here. Let's say, you know, somebody is saying, or, you know, statistics is saying, or, you know, different reports are saying, the household prices in Washington, or, you know, mean house prices in, you know, Washington, you know, this is equal to 300,000. Now, I would like to see what is the situation in my areas, which is spoken, and how it works. Let's see then what I do. I, you know, frame the hypothesis, which is called H0. Why H0? I'm just going to explain. Mu 0 equal to 300,000, mu 0. Or let it be, I just, you know, let it be very simple. So what I do, I just go with a sample. I go and collect the sample. So I just collect like 30 house prices in my neighborhood. So, and then I check this, and it says if 300,000, if it is coming close to that, you know, if coming in that bracket, okay, I can say this is true. If it is less or more, so that can also be proved. So basically, whatever is, you know, like your salary, for example, there's a, you know, average survey by different organizations, like, you know, job organizations like Chronicle and different other. They say average salary of software developer is 90,000 across USA. You want to see this, okay, you know, in my organization, or you want to see this, it is true or it is not true, then what you will do? You know, you go and collect the data of software developer in your organization, in your city, or in your, you know, neighborhood, and you will get to know whether this is true or not. It is higher, you know, it is your organization or your neighborhood or your area salary is higher than 90,000 or lower than 90,000 or 90,000. So this can be done using one sample hypothesis. Here you are just going to take one sample, either, you know, the prices of the houses throughout your neighborhood, you know, your neighboring area, or salary in your area, so on and so forth. So this is just, you know, I'm going to now demonstrate the mini tab. Then we will come on slides part. So let's say I'm just saying a house prices in my area. So as you know, this is a survey that 300,000, roughly I'm estimating 300,000 is housing prices. Okay, I'm just going to take the housing prices in my area. I go under, I'm just developing the random values, random data. Hmm. number of rows, let's say I'm just going to collect the 30 sample, and where I'm going to store the minimum value of, let's say I'm just going to put 275,000, and maximum value I'm going to put, let's say 400,000. Okay. So instead of getting you know, data from Zillow or from any, I'm just creating, you know, integers here, 30. Okay. Now I would like to test it. So I go under, since this is a sample, I don't know the population standard deviation. What I do, I go under statistics, basic statistics, one sample T. If you know the population standard deviation, you go under this one sample Z. Okay, right here. You can do both the things. You can summarize the data, or you can do this. You know, if you do mean standard deviation and 30, you know, then you can use this option. But I have everything right here, so I'm just going to pick perform hypothesis testing. Now, what is my benchmark? Benchmark or whatever my standard. Standard is 300,000, which I read in some articles or some survey or some news. So I put 300,000, yes. Now, here three options are there. And these options are, so by default, it's 95%. Three options are given, which is in the form of alternative hypothesis. So I can say equal to hypothesis mean, or less than, or greater than. So these are the three options. I'm just going to, okay, my, is there, so basically what is demonstrating, is there a difference in my area and 300,000? Is there a difference in my area home prices and hypothesis mean? Okay, I'm just going to do, you can see this. T value is 5.82, P value is this much. Then what I can say, so this is null hypothesis is equal to 300,000 and alternative is not equal to 300,000. Now I have to make the decision based on T value, based on P value. So T value is 5.82. Let's see what is the value of T at 5% level. So I go under graph probability distribution and view probability distribution. I go under this. I go under T distribution. Degree of freedom, we have 30 samples. So I'm just going to take 29 degree of freedom because 30 minus one. Shaded area, we are just checking 5%. So we are just looking at probability of 5%. And I'm just going to, so this is the 95% T distribution, means anything, you know, if calculated value is anything between this range, you accept null hypothesis. Otherwise, you reject null hypothesis. So where is your, what is your value is minus 5 point something, minus 5. So here we can see it is, 5.82. So 5.82 will certainly will come in this range. That means it is null hypothesis is rejected. What is the null hypothesis equal to? That means it says not equal to 300,000. Now the question is that if not equal to 300,000, it is greater than or it is less than, we will check. So these are the two other alternatives that we can see. So now again, I go back and I use the same process. And, one sample T test. Now exactly same thing. Now I'm just going to do another thing. The alternative says mean is less than hypothesized mean. Okay, I'm just going to do this. So, you know, the null hypothesis remains same. Alternative says mu is less than 300,000 and p-value is one, what we can, you know, so again, we let's look into the t value. T value is 5.82. And this is actually one side test, it's left or right, we have to. So here you can see, either you can see this or this. So let's look. This is 1.699. Here you can say state. And this is minus 1.699. So our case is this, because it is coming in this area. Means if any value less than 1.699, this is rejection area, rest of the area is accepting area. So this is only the tricky part, which test has to be applied. And very simple approach is under assistant. If you go under assistant, here you go hypothesis test. And under here, you can select the option, whatever. For example, what is your objective? Compare one sample with the target. So we are comparing the sample with the target. So one sample standard deviation, one sample so basically this is a percent, you know, proportion, this is a variance based, this is chi-square based, and this is mean based. So any hypothesis can be tested based on mean, based on standard deviation or variance, you can say, based on proportion, and based on, oh sorry, this is one sample standard, and this is chi-square goodness of fit. So these are the options. This we will cover in next session. So data column, I just go HP. Target is 300,000, as I said. Now the question, you know, the options are given here. Is the mean of HP greater than 300,000? So this is the option, you can select this. Is mean is less than the 300,000? Is mean is equal to, I mean, mean of HP differ from HP. So these are the three, you know, ways. So is mean of HP greater than 300,000? So I'm just going to check, because, you know, this our price, housing prices look like, you know, it is more than 300,000. So I'm going to check this, because, and alpha is, this, you know, you can decide based on 1%, 5%, 10%, only three options are here. Now I just go this. Sample size mean is 334,000, 90% lower bound is this, standard deviation is this, target is 300,000. Look into this. The mean of HP is significantly greater than the target. So this is our conclusion, that you can, you know, mean housing prices is significantly greater than the target, which is 300,000. So in our area, the mean housing price is more than 300,000 at 5% level of significance. This always you can say here. So this is another way to check it in order to reduce the complexity. Now I can just do another way. Assistance, hypothesis testing, and I go again on this. And now, is the mean is less than HP? So I'm just going to do this again. So here it clearly says mean of HP is not significantly less than target this. So first of all, the, you know, there's a difference between the housing prices in my area and the targeted or standard 300,000. But what difference? You know, my area is higher than the 300,000 price. Similarly, you can do for salary, or similarly, you can do for you know, pricing of the product. Similarly, you can, you know, if you do market research, you can get to know, okay, what is the product, your competitor products, and, you know, what are the their prices and what you are going to offer. So what would be your standard? Would it be more or less? So multiple ways you can apply this one sample hypothesis test in business application. Now I go on slide part. So I think it makes sense to you. What is the application before going into? So now we are going to start, you know, this is the process of hypothesis testing. Get an idea. So this is the process of hypothesis testing. Get an idea, formulate hypothesis, gather data, find test statistics, make decision, and revise your ideas. So these are the six steps. Now, the step one is state the hypothesis to be tested. What is hypothesis? Like, you know, here I assume, again, I have to go on whiteboard. Clear or so, what is hypothesis? There are two hypotheses. One is null hypothesis, which is normal return H0 and colon. And alternative is H1. It is written like this, or some people also write, you know, HA. So these are two ways to write alternative hypothesis. What is the null hypothesis? Let me make it very clear so that you can understand. So, null hypothesis, null means I'm saying this 300,000 is a benchmark value. 300,000 is a benchmark value of housing prices in my area, in entire, you know, survey or entire region or entire country. Now I would like to test, is there difference from, you know, this value in my sample, in my region? So I just check, you know, the mean. So basically H0 column mu equal to 30. That means, is there any difference in my area prices and this prices? If it comes, you know, my area prices with 95% confidence is also, you know, in that region of acceptance region, then I would say my area is also null means no. Null equal to no or equal to zero also. Null means
join the meeting.
So this means if the prices are same of 300,000, then there's no difference, then null hypothesis would be this. Alternative hypothesis would be mu not equal to 300, please bear with my writing because I'm just using mouse and making this writing. So this is alternative hypothesis. And now another hypothesis is, so this is not equal to this alternative hypothesis. You can directly get in Minitab. Now Now the second thing, mu equal to 300,000, 300K, this is H0 again. It says mu is equal to or less than 300,000. Then what would be the alternative hypothesis? Mu is greater than 300,000. Which is our case, you know, just, you know, with the data we have just seen. Now, second, in similar, the third option, H0 is, mu is greater than equal to 300K, and alternative is, mu is less than 300K. So these are the three permutation or combination of hypothesis testing, and those are reflected clearly in Minitab. So you don't need to do anything, just, but before that you have to think what numbers you need to put. So hypothesis testing is like this. So first thing, state the hypothesis to be tested. So basically this is the way to write. Since we don't have the assignment where you have to write all these things, therefore you have to only think and make it very clear in the, you know, fill in the blanks or MCQ. What level of consistency you can, you know, what level of inconsistency with the data lead to rejection of the hypothesis? This is called decision rule. You have to decide it. Collect the data necessary, like I have just made randomly 30 home prices. Make a decision, should be rejected. Take action based on decision. So the, you know, 5%, 10%, you know, this is decision rule. So null hypothesis, alternative hypothesis. State the hypothesis that, you know, always return in H0, H1 or. Now the technical language is, can hypothesis be proved? We cannot accept null hypothesis. We can only fail to reject it. So this is very important, you know, point that you need to remember, and whenever you do in practical way in your life, you only say these words roughly, you know, why we can do, we can prove, we cannot prove, we can reject or accept. These are different terms, but only this is the technical term that is highly, you know, make you the, you know, real decision science person. Efforts will be made to reject the null hypothesis. If H0 is rejected, we can, you know, conclude H1 is the case. So if H0 is, means null hypothesis is rejected, automatically alternative is the case. And if H0 is accepted, then, you know, there is no point of going to H1. H0 is sometimes called maintained hypothesis, active action alternative, because action may be required if we reject H0 in favor of. So either one is true, either null is true or second option. So now this is very important aspect that, you know, I will let you know with some example. Type 1 error and type 2 error. So here is the situation. You can see this matrix. H0 is true, H0 is false. Null hypothesis true or null hypothesis is false. Reject null hypothesis, fail to reject null hypothesis. If H0 is true, we reject the null hypothesis, that is called type 1 error. And this is also known as alpha error. If H0 is false, we reject H0, that is correct decision. If H0 is true and we fail to reject H0, that is correct decision. But if H0 is false and we are, you know, failing to reject H0, that is called type 2 error or beta error. So alpha error is based on the significance level. You can say the occurs alpha level of significance, which is 5%, 10%. And I will demonstrate that. Type 2 error is failure to reject null when it is false. This occurs within probability of beta. So I will let you know based on this also. We are not going to go into deep of these things. However, I will let you know why and how these errors are occurring in decision making. And so I'm not going into all this, but so decision critical values. So left tail test is this, two tail test is this, right tail test is this. That means null hypothesis mu is greater than and equal to mu zero. This is left side test when you are testing that mu is greater than the threshold value or 300,000, then this is the case. H1 is mu is, so this is the case, you know, mu zero and H0 and H1. Two tail test, which is very clear, equal to and not equal to. Right tail test, H1 is greater than mu zero. So these are the three possible situations we use hypothesis. And left tail test, so this is, you know, just simple. Decision rule is critical value and, you know, significance level, you can say. So for example, critical values at 95% minus 2.45 plus 2.45. So anything above minus 2.45, you know, anything less than minus 2.45 or more than plus 2.45, that is rejected here and rest is accepted. So this is very simple. When to use one or two sided test. This is very important because in many questions this has been asked. Two side hypothesis tested is used when direction is not equal to, you know, no interest in decision maker, you know, it is not an interest option, you know, you are not checking less than or equal to less than or greater than option. You are just checking it is, you know, equal to 300,000 or, you know, equal to a standard value, then this is two one-sided hypothesis test used when the tail of the distribution is a special importance of the researcher. So basically you are looking, you know, greater than, higher or less than, then we use this. So here you can reject in this case. There, this is the rejection, rest of the, you know, not rejection. So basically one-sided test, you can see what you are going to see and how you are going to see the critical value. So critical value, you can simply calculate using probability distribution. Type one error and two error, I'm just keeping it as it is and I will explain it later. So these are the critical values of 10%, 5%, 1% based on the. Now let's look into this question. Testing a mean with known population variance, and that means Z test. So here this is asking H0 is mu is less than equal to 216 millimeter. Mu 1 is 216 millimeter, mu greater than 216 millimeter. Decision rule is 5% level of significance. So 5%, this is H0 is asking less than 200. So basically this is the less than area. And the, you know, statistics we are going to calculate, if that falls under this left side region, the H0 is correct. Here you can see the reject. Here you can see this is a critical value at 5% level of significance, right side. So Now, based on calculation, if x bar minus mu zero sigma upon square root of n, this is a formula. So for calculating, so this is, you know, calculated, and this value is coming 2.152. That means that 2.512 will be in this region on rejection side, rejection region or dark region. So the decision would be the test statistics fall in right rejection region. So we reject the null hypothesis, which is saying less than 216, less than or equal to, and we conclude that, you know, H1 is greater than 216 at 5% level of significance. So this is a simple example. Now, based on the action, based on, you know, this, you have to take the action. Now that we have concluded that process is producing paper with an average width greater than the 216 mm or specification, it's a time to adjust the manufacturing process to bring average back to the specification. So similarly, you know, in manufacturing production, suppose you are making a, you know, iPhone, and iPhone standard weight is given 216 gram. If a standard weight and you want to check, you know, what is the iPhone weight, you know, you randomly take 30, 40 iPhone sample from, you know, manufacturing lot, and you weigh them, and you just try to check, you know, whether it, the, you know, whatever iPhone you are producing are matching with the standard weight of 216 gram, or it is less than or more than, or any product, you know, any product that you, that is there in production can be tested using. If it is more than, you have to adjust the, you know, machine in order to come with the proper standard. If it is less, then again, you have to adjust, you have to improve the quality part, you have to take some measures in order to bring the quality up to the 216 grams or whatever level you have, a standard you have decided. So there are two approaches in hypothesis testing. One is critical value, one is p-value approach. P-value is, let me, so critical value, you can clearly see, let's say this 1.645, this is a critical value. If anything is above, you know, beyond critical value, then we reject. There's another way of rejection or acceptance based on p-value. So p-value is the probability of the sample result. And, you know, assuming that H0 is true, p-value can be obtained, you know, so I can also tell you the p-value. Well, very simple, I'm not going into all this, but I'm just simply explaining. If p-value is less than significance level, we reject null hypothesis. So here, for example, so decision rule 5%, and based on this, let me do this calculation based on this. So I'm just going to use Minitab again, and I am going to explain. Here I go under statistics. Can you see my Minitab? Basic, one sample Z. Why I'm taking? Because, you know, it has population standard deviation. This is hypothesis value is 216,000, okay. And 216.007. 216.007. 0.023. N is 50. So this is, you know, based on, because here known standard deviation is given, you know, of the population is given here. Therefore, we are using one sample z test. Now, so here, option 95 means 5% significance level, and I'm just going to do simple option, which is hypothesized. Now let's do this. What is the p-value we are getting? So here, p-value is this. I'm just writing in percentage, which is 3.1%. What is the alpha we took? 5%. So the value is coming in 3.1%. We took 5%. That means we give more chances here, but this is coming in less. On the other side, z value is 2.15. I'm going to check how this z value is working here. So stat, basic statistic, probability. Now I'm going to use normal distribution. Mean is, so let's say z value, I'm just going to use. Can you see what is this probability is 1.78, means 1.5 here, you know. So try to understand, this is, you know, I'm just making it. So this is 1.5%. This is p-value it is given. This 2.5% is coming in this. If I do 5% graph probability distribution, and if I do, let's say, probability of 5%, and I just do this, and this is 1.645. So, oh, only this side I have to do both tail, so I just do, because both tail test has 2.5. Here you can see this is 1.96, and this is, which is half, 2.5%. So 1.96, which is coming in 2.5% here, but you know, our values are coming, whatever we calculated is in 1.5%. That means automatically it is going in the rejection region. So if p-value is less than the significance value, less than 5%, 10%, whatever p-value you are getting less than the significance level, you always reject null hypothesis. What you do? You always reject null hypothesis. Suppose, you know, if calculated value here, you know, we just calculated this, 2.15. If this value, and this is 3, means 1.5 on this side, 1.5 on that side, it is coming close to 3%. Let's say I'm going to do this at 99%. Am I able to do this? Yes. Let's see. Stat, basic statistics, one sample, Z test, and you know, all the numbers will remain same. I'm just going to check 99%. We are increasing the con. Now the, you know, exactly everything will remain same, but you can calculate, you can see this. For 99%, what is the critical value? Probability, probability distribution, I'm just going to, okay. And what are the values for 99%? So I'm just going to check the this thing, and I'm going to check this 1% 0.0001. So this is 99%, which is minus 2.56576 and plus 2. Now what is our calculated value? 2.15. 2.15 will be within acceptance region. Within accept. So we in 99% level of significance, we are going to accept this hypothesis. And now this is the only, you know, this is the only alpha error, you know, due to some chances, due to some reason. If you change the alpha level. Now again, I'm going to demonstrate one more simple thing. I hope I'm not making it complex. So again, I just, for example, I'm just going to use here 3%. For 3%, the calculated values are 2.17 and minus 2.17. And look into this one sample, and we are getting 2.15. So at 3%, which is, you know, here, 2.15 is coming in this region. So p-value is greater than significance level. So this is 3%, but you are getting p-value is 3.1%. Therefore, we are accepting the null hypothesis because this is coming less than this. Means our value is in this region. So always remember p value should be greater than alpha value. Then we accept H0 is accepted. If p value is less than alpha value or significance, then the alternative is accepted, or H1 or H0, you can say H0 is rejected and H1 is accepted. So always keep in mind. So you don't need to check the critical values. You don't need to check. And this is the same thing here. Now I'm just going to do one more simple thing to demonstrate alpha error for you. So I'm just going to check this 3.2. My significance level, I have just given this. And, you know, within significance range, you know, alpha, I have given alpha equal to 3.2%. If alpha is this, our value is nearly missing. We are nearly going into the rejection region because, you know, our value is coming 2.15, and here you are getting 2.144, which is very close to 2. And this could be reason, you know, if you change the alpha little bit, means I convert this alpha into alpha equal to 3.1, then so this could be the error that, you know, decision maker might have made when making a selection of significance level. If you change little bit significance level, your hypothesis is accepted. Means your hypothesis is correct, but you made a mistake in order to decide correct significance level. And that is what hypothesis is correct, but still you are rejecting because of the significance level or because of alpha. That is called alpha error or error one. I'm again going to demonstrate here. Let me do this same thing on 3.1%. So here I am just going to do 3.1%. And now, when we do 3.1%, our hypothesis is accepted. Only, you know, decimal percentage of alpha level is changing the hypothesis decision. So truly your hypothesis will be true, but due to this significance level, you are making wrong decision. And that is what is called alpha error. Is it making sense? Okay, so this is the case. Now, similarly, you can do based on proportion, based on standard deviation, based on and so p-value is, I hope you understand what is a p-value. Is it clear to you what is p-value? P-value is corresponding probability value of calculated statistics. So I just go under this again, you know, one more time I'm going to show the, so for example, we calculated this, Z value is coming 2.15. Corresponding this Z value, what is the probability where it is coming? So corresponding calculated value, this is P value on normal distribution. So if you either way to prove your hypothesis, use Z value and P value, both are correct. But simple, you can just, you know, based on significance level, you can understand p-value and you can make your conclusion. So this is another example. So mu is 142, not equal to, mu not equal to 142, and you can simply, you know, calculated value 24 minus 1, 23, and so basically, you can understand rest of the things very easy. Which test has to be used, that you can clearly understand that based on the standard given standard deviation of the population, use Z test. If not given, T test. If proportion, one proportion test. So basically, this is what I'm asking in this, you know, if you understand this, this is more than sufficient in this. A rule of thumb is normality. When do we assume the normality? Again, the same situation, you are using proportion test, then, you know, these are the conditions to assume normality, and then only you proceed to do the test. So for proportion, mu equal to mu, pi equal to pi zero, which is population, proportion equal to pi zero, which is given proportion. H1 is pi is less than pi zero. And, you know, two-tail test equal to, not equal to, and this is greater than, alternative is greater than this. So exactly the same thing we are going to do in proportion test, which is, and proportion test is under statistics, under one proportion test, and similarly, we are going to do this. So let me, so this is p-value again, exactly based on the same formula. So alpha, changing the alpha values can change the decision little bit, you know, if you are little bit here and there in alpha value, that will change the decision. That is possibility of error one. Now, what is the error two? What is the error two? So I'm just going to demonstrate here now beta error. So I'm just going to show you this, my mini tab again. hope you can see my mini tab. What about, you know, so this is the one way to, now I'm going to do another way, basic statistics, one sample z-test. What about if I change this value, hypothesized value? Due to some error, if hypothesized value is little bit here and there, this will also create the acceptance or rejection of the. So here, you know, and I did something wrong, just a minute. So just basic statistics and again, one sample Z test, I think I. So sample mean is coming this, sample is this, hypothesized is, you know, I'm just going to use 95, let's say. So using changing the value, p-value, what is the p-value? There we had 3%, here we have zero p-value. So what is the, it is not equal to 216.1. Now, if I change little bit less or something, let's see what happens. And let's say 215.8. Z value is keep changing, so not equal to again. So, you know, if the threshold or, you know, standard value is not done properly, that can also result in accepting and rejecting your null hypothesis due to that standard or benchmark value. If that is, you know, little bit changed or little bit, you know, you have not selected properly, and that can result, your hypothesis is correct, but you are rejecting the hypothesis, or your hypothesis is wrong, but due to selecting that, you are accepting the hypothesis, then that error comes, and that is called beta error, and that can be explained due to, there's a, you know, option under this, power and sample size. So here, you know, we have power selection and power, you know, this thing under this, and we do under this with, we don't need to do in this, you know, prerequisite. And we are just going to do this only understanding the. So this is, you know, alpha beta error. And now, basically, this is what I wanted to explain. Last thing about this is a standard deviation. It is, and p-value is zero. P-value can be zero. If p-value is zero, which is less than alpha value is 99% or 90. If p-value is zero, that means it is less than, it is coming out of the, you know, curve, you know, it doesn't belong to that, you know, normal distribution. That means alternative hypothesis is except null hypothesis is rejected and alternative is hypothesis accepted. Not rejected. So for null hypothesis, always rule of thumb, keep the null hypothesis. Null hypothesis is if p value is greater than alpha level, then you accept the null hypothesis. If p value is less than alpha level, then reject, or you can't accept. So if p value is zero, then, you know, in case of 5% or 1% alpha value, then yeah, it cannot be accepted. Now we are coming, you know, this is the last thing, which is about null hypothesis. In case of you are checking the variance, you are saying that, you know, that whatever, you know, there's a $50,000 variance in house prices in Washington state. Let me see if, you know, I want to check and I get the, you know. So I'm just going to use my same data here. For example, this is. So can you see this? I'm just going to check. Is it 50,000 or more? So I go under statistics, basic statistics, one variance here. So one or more each column. So I'm just going to. So hypothesize a standard deviation. So let's say I'm just going to give 20,000. And here I'm just going to. So basically, this is based on a standard deviation, or you can also use variance. So either way you can use. So let's do hypothesis, because you know the relationship between. So here, a standard deviation is this much. Did I do something wrong? For 30, you know, 30 items, this is a standard deviation, this is variance, and this is all, you know. Now p-value is zero. And that means you can, you know, test statistics is this much. That means sigma square is not equal to 20,000. Means we, you know, the variance of the housing prices is not equal to 20,000. Or I can do other way. One sample ways. Once. So instead of that, I'm just going to check, you know, this standard deviation. And you can see the sigma is not equal to, because again, this is coming zero. So this is chi-square test. This is based on chi-square distribution. We check the variance or standard deviation, like we did in the last class, last module. So this is basically based on chi-square test. So this is what I wanted to explain. And you know how to calculate the chi-square critical value, but we just wanted to make our decision based on p-value. So this is our module number 5. So if you have any question, please let me know. This is simple, you know. Now your most difficult module was module number 3, where you started with probability distribution. Now your journey for 520 will be easier. Once you understand all these concepts, it will be easier. I can only tell you 520 is easier than this, because, you know, it takes time to understand these concepts. Once you understand, it is very easy for 520 to proceed. If you don't have any question, yeah, go ahead, Kate.
Hello and good evening. Thank you for your help today. I was curious if we could talk about number 8 on the fill in the blanks homework. Mm-hmm. I have it here in front of you if you want, and I have been running it in Minitab, but mm-hmm. I can't tell if it's an entry error or what's going on my end.
Okay, let me check.
It's a proportion.
Mm-hmm.
And it's the one about 20% of teenagers purchasing a new iPhone.
Mm-hmm.
This year, a sample of 260 randomly chosen teenagers showed that 39 had purchased a new iPhone. Mm-hmm. To test whether percentage has decreased, the p-value is. And so I crunched it in Minitab. Well, I crunched it. I made the proportion. And then I crunched it in Minitab. And I keep getting 0.044. And mm-hmm. I know that's not right, but I was hoping we could talk about it.
Okay, just a minute. Okay, so last year, 20% of...
Oh, hold on, it's number 8. Number 8.
So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, six, seven, eight. Last year, 20% of teenagers purchased a new iPhone. This year, a sample of 260 randomly chosen teenagers showed 39 had purchased a new iPhone. To test whether the purchase has decreased the p-value. So?
So I did the, first of all, I figured out the the mu, which was 0.2. The proportion is 39 divided by 260. And then I graphed it in Minitab using the proportion with the events of 39 and the trials of 260. And then I did the random hypothesis test, or the perform the hypothesis test. And just for that, I put in 0.2.
And so now we would like to check whether, you know, this year that it has been decreased or increased. So
it wants to know if it's decreased.
Okay, let me read one more time. So here we have, you know, what option do we need to use?
We need to use the, can you click on them?
Can we put normal approximation? What is the n pi equal to? What is n pi?
0.15.
N pi. So 0.15.
Yep.
0.15 and 260. So yeah, this is exceeding the 10, which is the, you know, it has to be greater than or equal to 10. And 1 minus pi, this has to be greater than equal to 10. So this condition you must, you know, follow before, you know, going through. So if this is fulfilled, let me go further.
I'm sorry, you didn't just ask me a question, did you?
No, I'm just, you know, I'm just saying, you know, you always check the n pi, this condition, which I, for normality. So if normal, okay, proportion or hypothesis test, this is simply we are, which option do we need to choose? As proportion is less than hypo, this is alternative option.
Right.
So this.
P-value.
What is the question? This is the simple question.
Okay, I just continued to get 0.044 every time I tried it. So I think something happened maybe with the normal approximation.
Basically, probably because, you know, n pi, this condition must be, you know, remembered when you are doing this.
Right. Okay. Okay.
Only, you know, otherwise this chapter, this module is very simple, to be honest, to tell you. Only few things you need to remember, rest is automatically done by Minitab.
I believe choosing between normal question that changes the Minitab answer. Okay, so maybe if I chose exact, I would have gotten 0.044 and that was my error. Okay. I do have another question, but I wanted to let everybody else have a chance first.
Any other? I believe choosing between normal and exact change the Minitab answer. Exactly. Yeah. This happens. So, you know, if you, therefore, on the slide, I can go back one more time here and I can emphasize on this because normal approximation has, so
I don't think we can see your slides if you're trying.
Yeah, I'm just going to, So again, I'm just going to share my slide. Can you see now?
Yeah, we can.
So, you know, this is clearly written, you know, written here that, you know, we need to follow this condition in case of normal approximation. And I think that we started learning this from binomial distribution, how to convert binomial to, you know, and what is the situation when n pi equal to greater than or equal to 10. And so this is applicable. Any other? Yeah, that change, you know, I can demonstrate one more time here, which is, again, I go this basic statistic, one proportion, and under option, I don't choose, I prefer exact method. What is the value we get? P-value we get here, 0.023. However, we don't get statistics value. So here, for example, you get the Z value in this case. If you choose the normal approximation, because, you know, in normal approximation, Z value, Z means normal, you know. So you get the calculated value or Z value. But here, if you don't choose, you can just get the P value.
Okay. I have one more question, and I was wondering if you could look at number 14 on the same quiz also.
Okay, so I think I answered that. I think there's a, you know, so. Just a minute. Okay. Number 14, I think you asked me, I fixed a little bit, you know, the answer has been fixed, which is 0.7 something.
Oh, so I didn't ask you that question, but okay. Maybe that's why it needed to be fixed.
Okay, 1, 2.
On the fill in the blank?
Yeah, I'm just looking. What is the question? Can you repeat it?
Yes. Doko Manufacturing claims that its alkaline batteries last at least 40 hours on average in a certain type of portable CD player. But Tesla, on a random sample of 18 batteries from a day's large production run, shows that the mean battery life is 37.8 with a standard deviation of 5.4. In a left-tailed test at alpha equals 0.05, what is the test statistics?
So here you just go, the statistics, basic statistics, is a t-test. T-test. So
hold on, slow down, I want to do it with you. Sample t, got it, and summarize data. So the sample size I have is 18.
Mm-hmm.
Sample mean that I have is 37.8. Standard deviation is 5.4. Hypothesis test, the hypothesized mean is 40. Then we go into options and we want to do a left-tailed test, which means we want the mean.
It is 90%, 95%, what?
It said, alpha equals 0.05.
Yeah, that means automatically 95%. And test statistics is?
Let's see.
This is the value.
Negative 1.73. That's the answer I got in. It said it was wrong. And then I tried.
Actually, some of you, you know, you were doing that. I think using Excel, you know, in Excel, you were, you know, 2-3 students sent me the screenshot of, I think, the Excel calculation, and it says minus 1.72. You know, the digits are like, you know, 5-6 digit after decimal, and probably that might be not the case. It is just, you know.
I entered negative 1.73 and it was wrong. So I have a different answer here too, negative 1.7285. So I'll try the negative 1.73.
How do you get that number? You know, because you are using Excel or some other tool?
I was doing the formula that is basically at the sample mean minus mean over standard deviation.
Basically, you are doing a manual thing, probably.
The long way, yeah.
Okay, so this is, you know, long way is always good to understand every concept. But, you know, once you understand, this is the, so.
Okay, I'll resubmit again with negative 1.73, and I'll just write you a message if it doesn't seem to be working on mine.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, super. Well, thank you so much for your help.
You're welcome. And so 520 will start, you know, on 8th. So we want to finish this course on 7th, you know. So please, I mean, I'm just requesting everyone to submit everything by Sunday, 7th of February. Okay, thank you. Thank you very much. Have a good night. And if you have any question, I'm available to answer your questions through email, through Canvas. Okay, bye-bye.
Bye, thank you.
Bye.
Thank you.
Bye.
Have a good night.